Hey, before we start the video, I think it's finally time for me to dig up my time capsule of tech predictions. Let's go. Let's see how accurate these predictions were. Prediction number one, invest in Bitcoin. Yeah. Prediction number two, AI.
Yeah.
Prediction number three, NetworkChuck Academy will be the number one destination for IT training. Another round of successful predictions. Now back to the video.
Now you're probably feeling pretty good. We've shown you a ton of security features that Windows has to protect you, but there's more. They have another layer of security that honestly you need. Because guess what? Despite all of these security features we've talked about, all the protections that Microsoft puts in, the castles and the fortresses and the walls and the moat, attacks still happen. Computers still get infected. Hackers are smart and they're always evolving, so Microsoft is having to do the same thing. We're talking about the last security feature in our security series here. Let's go ahead and launch device security once more in our wonderful world of Windows. And we're gonna jump into the place we haven't been yet, device security. Now you'll notice that I have like a, that's a pretty scary message. It's the one app I don't have a green check mark on. I don't like that. You'll see why. Actually, it tells you right now, memory integrity is off. Your device may be vulnerable. Don't like that. Let's go to settings and check out why. We'll go to the settings here in a bit, but I want to jump into just the device security area. The first thing we have here is core isolation. What this does is it takes core processes that your computer depends on to run, things that are super important, and they isolate them from everything. Even your operating system, even the Windows OS installation you have here, they isolate it, mainly so that hackers and malicious software cannot get to those processes. If they could, it'd be bad. Now, the way it keeps this isolation is through virtualization. Think that browser control we had earlier, the isolated browser, it uses virtualization to keep like a separate little computer away from your main computer. Now, right now, my memory integrity, one of the main features of this, is off. Probably because this machine I'm using right now itself is a virtual machine. We're not gonna get into that. But if I jump in there, can I enable it? Let's see. Oh, cool, I can. No problems at all. I will have to restart. And it tells us right here what's going on. Prevents attacks from inserting malicious code into high security processes. Now, the security processor is actually pretty interesting and powerful. You might have heard of this. It's called TPM, or the Trusted Platform Module. And the reason you might have heard of this is because it prevented many people from installing Windows 11 on their older laptop or desktop machine. I ran into a few issues too. Because what it wants you to have is a hardware chip on your motherboard, a separate chip on your motherboard, hardware, physical, to hide your credentials and encryption keys instead of having that in software. It's another layer of protection, and Microsoft was trying to move people towards that, and that's why they have this TPM for Windows 11. Now, why do this? Well, putting it on separate hardware versus having it live in software makes it almost impossible for attackers and hackers to get to that information. They want your passwords, they want your sensitive data, but if it's somewhere else, harder to get. Now I can jump in there and see what the details are. Not really anything we care about right now. And one thing that security processor will help with, and something you'll probably want to enable, which most people don't honestly, is BitLocker drive encryption. Let's click on that setting real quick. Manage BitLocker drive encryption. Notice it pulled up my C drive and it's like, hey, you've got BitLocker off. Now what is BitLocker? What is encryption? Well, encryption takes your data. Let's say this is a piece of data. And this data is a text file that simply says, Bob. If a hacker or attacker were to get that piece of data, if they were to steal my laptop, pull the hard drive out, plug it into their computer, they could pull that data off and go, Bob, I see it. But if I were to encrypt that data, or hide it through algorithms to where you would need a special key to even read it, it would look like this to anyone else. Just gibberish. Hackers would be able to do nothing with this information. They would need that key that would be stored on your TPM chip, for example, your encryption key. So that's what BitLocker does. It encrypts your hard drive to where if hackers were to get a hold of that, it wouldn't matter. They can't access your data. It's been BitLocked. They've locked your bits. Now also, I have to note that this is only available on Windows 10 and 11 Pro, also Enterprise and Education. Now through the process of turning on BitLocker and encrypting your drive, they will give you a recovery key. So in case your system crashes, you have to reinstall Windows, you'll need that recovery key to access all those files again. Otherwise, it's even blocked from you accessing it. And look, you can even get BitLocker to go. It sounds like a cheesy restaurant ploy, I don't know. So that pretty much wraps up our talk on security in Windows. They put a lot of features in to help you feel safe, and they actually do keep you safe with a lot of things. The biggest danger is probably gonna be you, going in here and disabling certain things so you can run a certain application, have fun with something, maybe forget you turn the setting off, suddenly you're hacked because you left some protection off. So my caution to you and for your users and for your family is to leave all the best security settings on. And normally the default settings are the best. Beyond that, it's just education, because Microsoft cannot protect you against everything. Just because you have green check marks across the board does not mean you're gonna be protected. You gotta be safe on the internet. Don't download things you don't know what they are. Don't go to websites that you don't know what they are. And that's my spiel on security. I'll see you in the next episode.
Oh, you're still here? If you want to see more great IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.